Hello, this is Hiroshi Yamazoe. This time I will talk about parents and society. I am a person who experienced severe hikikomori for a long time. I was having problems with my parents. And when I look at social networking sites in Japan, I see that there are so many hikikomori people who have problems with their parents, like me. And there are many people, not just hikikomori people, who have problems with their parents. Recently, a new jargon, doku-oya, has been popular in Japan. The term doku-oya means toxic parents. In short, it is the bad parents who cause harm to their children. For example, the parents who abuse or neglect their children. In today's Japan, such parents are called doku-oya. It seems that there are many such parents in Japan. What can we do to get away from these kind of parents? I made a video topic about hikikomori and parents before. As I said in the video, I believe that becoming financially independent is a very powerful way to escape from doku-oya. I am also in a much better situation now that I am financially independent and living away from my parents. And I read this book yesterday. The author of this book was abused by his parents and suffered a lot. After that, he went through a lot of hardships and achieved social success, and became financially independent and finally got away from his parents. This book tells the story of how he got rid of his doku-oya. And in the book, I also found that becoming financially independent from parents is a critical factor in escaping from doku-oya. The point is that as long as we financially depend on our parents, there is a master-slave relationship arising. If we cannot live without our parents' money, we have no choice but to obey our parents, even if they are bad parents. I think that is the core of the suffering in the problem in doku-oya. Of course, maybe there are some exceptions. Even if a person becomes independent from his or her parents, there are still cases in which the parents will persistently follow him or her and continue to attack. But I think that's a rare case. So I think that most doku-oya problems can be solved by becoming independent from their parents. So I believe that people who are tormented by doku-oya should aim to become independent from them without giving up hope in order to escape from doku-oya. I think there are countless ways to become financially independent because in this day and age, we have the internet. It is possible to earn money using the internet in various ways. So there are many opportunities. It will need luck, wisdom, and energy, but there is hope always. And if you cannot achieve financially independence. You have the option of simply moving out of your parents' house by yourself, but in that case, you will need someone to help you instead of your parents, or you will be living with social welfare. However, you can free yourself from Tokuya. And the book describes one type of abuse that is typical in Japan, which is committed by Tokuya. It is 教育虐待. 教育虐待 is when parents violently force their children to study. Study is a broad concept, but 教育虐待 is when parents violently force their children to study in a way that parents they think it is right. Many Japanese parents consider that very important for their children to be successful in the entrance exam of a high level university. In Japan, parents frequently and violently force their children to study for it. My parents were the same way. I refused to go to school when I was in elementary school. And since then, my parents have abused and neglected me. In Japanese society, academic achievement is very important. So, not going to school is considered like an unforgivable sin in Japan. In Japan, there is a strong belief in academic achievement, and it's not just a belief, but a social construct based on it. This can be seen in the statistics as well. There is a clear difference in annual income and unmarried rate depending on people's educational achievement. I think it's like the caste system in India. People in Japan are obsessed with educational achievement, and they are obsessed with high-level universities, not normal universities. By graduating from a high-level university, they move up to a higher caste. Graduating from a high-level university like the University of Tokyo makes he or she a Brahmin, while a high school graduate is like a Sudra. And people like me who have not received any education since elementary school are outcast in Japanese society. In Nagoya, where I live, there was such an incident 4 years ago. A 12 years old boy was stabbed to death by his father because he did not study as ordered by the father. I think it's crazy, but there seem to be a lot of parents who have this kind of ideology. So many people are obsessed with going to a good university. People have absolute faith in academic achievement. Why is this happening in Japan? I think it is because the parents who are actually committing 教育虐待 against their children have themselves been discriminated against in Japanese society based on their educational achievement. I believe that 教育虐待 will never end because discrimination based on educational background will always exist in this Japanese society. I think there is a problem in maintaining that discriminatory structure itself. As long as people affirm the discriminatory structure and strive to be on the side of discriminator rather than on the side of the discriminated, the discriminatory structure will not disappear, and the majority of people in Japanese society want to be the discriminator side. Therefore, the discrimination based on educational achievement will never end. So, 教育虐待 will never end as well. And today, here I have invented a new word. It is 読社会. 読社会 means toxic society. I think there is a 読社会 behind 読親. I think we should leave the 読社会 as well as the 読親. People who are suffering from 読親 can be freed from 読親 by becoming independent from their parents. Likewise, people get away from this 読社会 by becoming independent from the society. Nowadays, we have the internet. Even now, I am communicating with people across the countries. This is something that anyone can do. It is possible to connect with people across countries. So I think it's possible to live beyond the borders, border of any society. For example, international digital nomads are actually walking across countries using only the internet. This makes it possible to overcome the 読社会. That may be too idealistic. I don't think it's easy. It may be impossible. But I think it is at least possible to reduce the connection between 読社会. In any case, I will not give up and will continue my efforts to do so. So thank you for watching. I will post more and more videos. If you would like, please subscribe to the channel. So thank you and goodbye.